Let's give God a hand praise on this morning. Come on, let's praise God this morning. God is worthy of all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise belongs to here. I heard it in your voice. Amen. I won't call your name out. Amen. We thank God for being here this morning. Let's come on. Let's give God praise. Those who's watching on live stream or however, give God the praise and the honor and the glory that's due unto him. We thank God for all that the Lord is doing, for God is doing great things for us right now in the midst of whatever may be going on. And there's a lot going on, but in the midst of all this going on, God is doing great and mighty things for us. We thank God for the prayer this morning. Thank God for the ones who are here on this morning. Thank God for all that he is doing. I know I'm repeating myself, but I appreciate all that the Lord is doing. I don't want to go without appreciating God, because I realize he don't have to do the things that he's doing. And in all of this, we can still see the beauty of holiness. Hallelujah. Praise God. Because when God is in it, and the situation may not be beautiful, the situation is what it is, but God is the one to make things beautiful in the midst of the Red Sea. Hallelujah. When they had to go across the sea and they know how they're going to get across it, God made it beautiful and made a path for them to go through. Hallelujah. So that's why the scripture says he turns the bitter water sweet and he brings beauty out of ashes. God can take ashes. That just amazed me. And he can make something beautiful. And then he reminded me one day that we're made out of the dust. And some of y'all are beautiful, but you're made out of dust. You are literally made out of dirt. And I'm made out of dirt, but God can take dirt. Hallelujah. When you look at yourself, hallelujah. We all was made out of the dirt, the dust. It said the dust. Hallelujah. Amen. And so we just thank God for how he makes all things beautiful. We've been talking about the beauty of holiness, and I don't know when this is going to end and go to something else, but God knows what he's doing, and so I'm just going in the way that God has given us, because it's beautiful. It's beautiful. This life is beautiful. Hallelujah. My sister passed at 36, 37 years old many years ago. Hallelujah. And the song they sung at her service is, life can be beautiful. And it can, even though she passed at a very young age, hallelujah, she had a beautiful life. Even in the midst of her sickness and all that she went through, she had a beautiful life. She didn't allow nothing to stop her, hallelujah. When she couldn't go to church, she would have Bible study in her home, and neighbors and different ones would come over, hallelujah, and she would share the word of God with them, hallelujah. And even though she's been dead ever since 1966, hallelujah, when her name come up, praise God, you see the effect that it had on those that she touched. Amen. So your life can be beautiful no matter what it may be, no matter what you may be going through. God can make your life beautiful if you will allow him. We're going to go to Isaiah, and we're preparing our prayer journal for 2021, if the Lord says the same. And this is one of the devotions that the Lord gave me. And so when that time comes, you will find this in your devotion. And I was not planning on sharing it this morning. Hallelujah. But I know that when God gives you something, when that time comes, I've already wrote it. Amen. I'm working on it right now. Hallelujah. Even as I speak. But the Lord said to share a little bit of it this morning with you. Amen. And so we're going to see what the Lord will say to us on this morning. But as Isaiah, the 35th chapter of Isaiah, and the 8th through the 10th verse, and we just see what the Lord says. And he says, and a highway shall be there, and a way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for those, the wayfaring men, though fools shall not err therein. No lion shall be there, nor any raven beast shall go up thereon. It shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there. And the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with songs and everlasting joy upon their heads. And they shall attain joy and gladness, and sorrow and silence shall flee away. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word. We don't know how much we're going to bring out on today, but we're just going to share what comes to me on this morning. He said, a highway shall be there and a way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. There's a highway. There's a song we used to sing. There's a highway to heaven. And only the pure in heart can travel on that highway. Hallelujah. And this is Old Testament. So this has been many, 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 many years ago. But as you read Isaiah, and God has me in Isaiah and had me in it for quite a while now, Isaiah prophesied many things. He prophesied the birth of Christ. He prophesied the death of Christ. He even prophesied one of the devotions. I'm not going to get into it right now. But he even prophesied concerning the New Jerusalem in heaven. And when you read it and you find in your devotion, those who go through the prayer journal, the consecration with us, and we'll be sharing in the mornings, amen, amen. But as you read Isaiah, he even talks about heaven. And so I was in one particular chapter, and he's describing heaven, and he says the same thing that John the Revelator said in Revelation. It's the same thing, and this is thousands and thousands of years later, but God allowed him to see these things before time. And one thing that he seen was this highway of holiness. Hallelujah. Praise God. And we thank God for the highway of holiness. And he let us know that everything cannot travel. That's what it's saying. Everything cannot travel on this highway. Only the pure in heart can travel on this highway. So how did that happen? What do I do to get on this highway? How do I get my heart pure? You have to be washed in the blood of Jesus. You have to accept the Lord into your life. Hallelujah. And when you accept the Lord into your life and you give your life to him, you repent of your sins, then you can travel on this highway. And it's the highway of holiness, and it is not a denomination. In the Pentecostal church, as we was growing up, we would hear this scripture a lot. And we also would hear Hebrews 12 and 14, which says, follow peace with all men and holiness without, which no man should see the Lord. And so because our denomination was holiness, many felt like we were the only ones. But no, this has nothing to do with a denomination. This is a lifestyle. Hallelujah. We're to live holy, and we all have to travel this same highway. And the saints of old would call this Highway 66, because there are 66 books in the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. And we have to have God's word in us so we'll know that we're on the right highway. On this highway, God gives us directions. Hallelujah. When you travel in a highway, you have signs to let you know that you, and it guides you and it leads you to get to California. I believe it's Highway 66 and 54. It's been so many years now, but you stay on that route. You don't get on another route. You stay on that route. You can't make no turns. And then if you do make the turns, it's still the same highway, but you make the turns as you follow the signs on that highway. Amen. And so we have to stay in the word of God from Genesis to Revelation. And the Bible let us know that God's word comes to instruct us. It comes to guide us. It comes to chastise us. It comes to the word of God. We have the God word. It leads us in every area and every aspect of our life. Whatever you need, you can find it in God's word. But you have to stay on Highway 66. Praise God. You have to do it as God. And then God says some of his word is for our example. There's some things that's in the Old Testament people exit out. Say, we don't need that no more. No, you still need that because it's a guide. And he said in one scripture to read and to study and to know and see the mistakes that Israel, the children of Israel, made and not fall into the same condemnation that they fell into. And so we need all of God's word. Hallelujah. Praise God. We have to follow all of God's word, and we have to stay on this highway. We have to stay in God's word. Hallelujah. So we will know that we're walking according to his word, because God is calling for holiness. And Brother Taiwan on Friday, last Friday, he brought a beautiful word, and he talked about the Bible said for us to be perfect, even as our Father in heaven is perfect. And many people, a lot of times we run from that. When we can't be perfect, we can't be perfect. And he said that the real original, that word when you study, that perfect means to be mature. To be mature. And many of us that have studied know now that that means to be mature. But to be mature in Christ, not to continue stand being babies, to grow up. And God is perfecting all of us. That's why the scripture said, being confident of this very thing. That he that has begun a good work in you, he will finish it, he will complete it, and he will bring it to pass. So God is making us perfect, but you never can become perfect. You never can grow up. You never can be mature if you settle and just want to stay being a baby. You just want to stay on milk. You don't want nothing else but milk. Or you don't want nothing else but sweets. You don't want nothing else but desserts. You don't want no vegetables. You want everything to be fried. Hallelujah. You'll never be the person that God wants you to be. Hallelujah. So God wants us to be balanced. God wants us to be balanced, to be able to enjoy the things of life. And we can. But to enjoy those things, we have to be mature in him so we'll know when to go forward, when to step back. Hallelujah. When to stop. Hallelujah. Enjoy what we eat, but know when to stop. Enjoy what we do, but know our limits. And then also know there's some things God said, don't touch. Don't handle. Hallelujah. The unclean thing. But we have to have his word in us, and the holiness has to be in us. A desire to live holy, you have to have a desire. You have to first have a willing mind. Hallelujah. You don't get off this highway. Well, I'm not going to take this highway. I'm going to take this one over here. I think it'll take me where I need to go. No, stay on the main path. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to thy own understanding. And all your ways acknowledge him, for he shall direct your path. Your paths. He knows the paths of life. He knows, but whatever direction your life may be going, you still have to stay on this highway to get where God wants to take you. So a highway should be there, a way. It didn't say ways. It didn't say ways. It said a way. Hallelujah. So we try to take our ways. It's not your ways. It's his way. It's not what you think, but it's what God said. Have you ever been on a highway and you thought, you know what? I think I'll make a turn here, and I think it'll still take me where I need to go, and you end up lost? You end up spending hours trying to get, or an hour, maybe not hours, but you may lose an hour. We say an hour. You may lose an hour trying to get back on the main highway. And we know things are kind of somewhat different, so it may not take as long now. But you can get so far off that it's hard to get back on. Hallelujah. And so you want to stay on the main path. And it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean, there it is, the unclean shall not pass over it. In other words, we got to be clean. And the only way we can be clean is through Christ. And then once he cleans us, we have to stay clean. We have to stay clean. Hallelujah. And how do we stay clean? By staying in God's word. Wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his ways? By taking heed to the word of God. We have to stay in God's word so we can stay clean, because it said no unclean thing can travel on this highway. And then if you happen to fall, if you happen to make a mistake, you get up, you brush yourself on. Lord, forgive me. Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, help me. Lord, strengthen me. And still stay on the highway. Keep on traveling. Keep on going forward. No unclean should pass over it, but it should be for those, the wayfaring men, though fools should not err therein. God has made it so plain that even a fool don't have to err. Even a fool can become wise. Hallelujah. If they trust in God, if they get on this highway by asking God to forgive them of their sins and to cleanse them, and then do the things that God has said, God will open up his word to you, and he will reveal his word to you. Hallelujah. And you don't necessarily, now there's nothing wrong with college. I have to be so careful when I speak here, because I believe in college. I believe in schooling. Hallelujah. But God, that we have many of our forefathers that was not able to go to school. Hallelujah. For whatever reason, they had to work in the fields and they couldn't go. And at that time, they didn't have the money and the need, the the proper things that they need to be able to go to school. Hallelujah. But God educated many of our forefathers. Hallelujah. In his word. Hallelujah. Before we knew Greek and all the different languages, God would reveal to them what his word was saying. Hallelujah. And they would teach it to others. Hallelujah. There's been some that God even taught them how to read. Hallelujah. Because they was on the highway of holiness and they begin to get in God's word and they begin to study the map. They begin to study the map. Hallelujah. They begin to take out times and study the map. And God began to lead and direct them and guide them. And they were able to be a blessing to others. So even a fool will not err if they trust in God. If they stay on the highway and not get off and just trust in him, even when they feel like getting off, they stay on the highway. Because this is what the map says. My feelings and my instincts and all that shit tells me different, but this is what the map said. So stay with the map, and we know now we have GPS. Hallelujah. And we know the GPS that man made, sometimes they get off. Hallelujah. But most of the time, they do pretty good. Hallelujah. But there are times they get off. But God's GPS, it don't get off. You can trust it fully. Hallelujah. Amen. So stay with the map. Stay with the word of God, and you will not err. God will give you all that you need in him. And then it says, no lion shall be there, nor ravens, beasts shall go up their own. God is letting us know that as you begin to study that there can be no sin. No sin. Many times they would bring this out, we don't have those type of spirits, the beast-type spirits. Hallelujah. Praise God. Whatever beast is speaking of, we don't have those spirits. The spirit that we have is the spirit of God. And the spirit of God gives us to be kind and loving and sweet. The Spirit of God give us to follow peace with all men, there it is, and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Amen. God changed and he takes that beast spirit out of us. Oh, God. And he give us a spirit like his, a spirit of a lamb. Hallelujah. And even in Isaiah, he speaks of the lamb. Hallelujah. He speaks of the new Jerusalem and how the lamb and I want to go into all that. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. So we have the spirit of Christ in us. Praise God. He don't. No lying, no stealing, no adultery, no fornication, no tale-bearing, hallelujah, no gossiping. All that has to go, hallelujah. That can't be on this highway. It can't be on this highway. All that has to go. Only the pure in heart. Pure, you have to be pure in your heart. For the Bible said, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. So you have to keep your heart pure. Even though no one may know and you have things in your heart that you know that shouldn't be, you got to get those things out of your heart if you want to remain on this highway of holiness. Amen. So, but God has given us his spirit. So no beast spirit, no nothing that's not like God can travel on this highway. It should not be found there, see? But the redeemed shall walk there. Only the redeemed can travel on this highway. Only them that has been redeemed by the blood of Christ. Hallelujah. Those that have been chosen, those that have said yes to him. The Bible said many are called, but few are chosen. Hallelujah. God has called all of us to repentance, but some will not accept, some will not receive it. Hallelujah. Praise God. He has redeemed, he called for all of us to be changed. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Hallelujah. And so God has redeemed us, from the curse of the law. He has redeemed us from ourselves. He has redeemed us from I can't help it. God has redeemed us. I can now do all things through Christ, which strengthened me, because I'm a new person. I'm not the old man I used to be. Hallelujah. You're not the old woman that you used to be. I've been redeemed. I'm traveling a different highway now. I'm traveling a different road now. Hallelujah. And I must stay on this road because the highway of holiness, it leads me to heaven. Hallelujah. We all already have eternal life, but we have to continue to stay with the Lord. Hallelujah. And not walk away from him. He won't walk away from us. Our salvation is secure, but we can walk away from him, but he will not walk away from us. So know that you're redeemed and stay on this highway, because this highway, it leads to home. And the rest of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with songs of everlasting joy upon their heads. Oh, we can sing the joy songs. We can sing the songs and the praises of God. But oh, on that day, we can sing right on from this life right into eternity. And when we make it into heaven, and when he said, well done, thou good and faithful servant, we will never, because we can sing now. The Bible said to sing and make melody in your hearts and whatever. And so we do that. But when we get to heaven, there won't be no interruptions. Hallelujah. There won't be no, today I'm going to church, and now COVID-19 has came, so now we can't go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then there won't be no interruption. We can continue to praise and magnify the Lord with no interruptions. Hallelujah. We can have that joy, and we have joy. But the joy, when we get there, again, there won't be no more sorrow. And that's what it's talking about. As you read, it won't be no more sorrow. It won't be no more dying. There won't be no more sickness. The Bible said all these things will be passed away. Hallelujah. And all things will become new. And so we will attain joy and gladness and sorrow. And all that, when you have sorrow, all that it brings, all of that will be passed away in the new, it speaks of that, in the new Jerusalem. All of that will be passed away. But the only way that's going to be, it is that we have to stay on the highway of holiness. Don't vary. Don't allow nobody. Hallelujah. There will be those that will come and say, come over here and travel with me. Hallelujah. You can get there quick if you travel with me. But say, no, I must stay on this highway of holiness. So we thank God for you on today. Take that you've heard on today. Those that may say, well, I'm not on that highway. Hallelujah. You can get on it right now. Jesus already paid the toll. He gave that to me either last night or this morning. He's already paid the toll. You know, you usually have to pay the toll, but he done already paid the toll. Hallelujah. That's why he said the redeemed, Sister Saida. I went back and I looked at that, and redeemed. That means he's already taken care of it. But it's up to us. See, when we get to the toll gate, it's already been paid. But we do have to say, now, Lord, you forgive me. Lord, you wash me. Lord, come into my life. Lord, I need you. And then he'll let you know the toll has already been paid. You're now on this highway. Travel it. Don't get off. Stay with it. Hallelujah. And then one day, you will literally see the Lord face to face. But until then, stay up on this highway. Occupy until he come. Now, Lord, we just thank you for your many blessings. We thank you for your goodness, your mercy, and for your outstretched hand. Lord, we thank you for the beauty of holiness. And we thank you for this highway. You said we could travel on this highway. There is a highway, and it's the highway of holiness. And, Lord, so we thank you for this highway. And, Lord, we ask that you help us to stay on this highway. Help us not to vary, oh, God, but to stay and keep our eyes focused upon you, to keep straight, to drive, and to go forward. So, God, we thank you, because everything we need, we find it in your word. Oh, God, so help us to stay with your word, oh, God, no matter what, to stay with your word, and it will lead us, and it will keep us, oh, God, as we travel on the highway of holiness. Now, wash us, cleanse us, and make us whole. Forgive us of any sin. Whatever's lacking our life, we ask that you take it from us and make us more like you. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Amen. God bless you. God keep you as you travel on this highway of holiness.